The immediate past Attorney General and Minister of Justice Abubakar Malami, who presented the report as chairman of the committee, told the president that the implementation of the recommendations will entrench constitutionalism, democratic principles, and separation of powers. At the moment, he said, most states honored the constitutional provisions for financial autonomy in the breach than in observance, noting that as the last hope of the common man, the legislature and judiciary should be given autonomy.
The recommendations clearly, Your Excellencies, spell out that if uniform modules for implementation of financial autonomy for state legislature and state judiciary are approved for implementation across the 36 states of the Federation, it will no doubt strengthen Nigeria's democratic principles, practices, and public governance at the state level, thereby guaranteeing independence of all the three arms of government at the state level. In this connection, Your Excellency, we pray, Mr. President, to issue a presidential executive order so as to aid seamless implementation of the recommendations.
President Muhammadu Buhari, who thanked the committee for a job well done, said the government will study the report and take appropriate decisions in the best interests of the country.
The people we represent depend on leadership to make sure that justice is done in whatever will eventually involve them. So the trust the ordinary people have in us must not be compromised. This administration will take your report very seriously. And I assure you that I will make sure that we stabilize the system.
The Presidential Implementation Committee on Financial Autonomy for the State Legislature and Judiciary, in compliance with Sections 121, Subsection 3 of the 1999 Constitution as amended, was inaugurated by President Muhammadu Buhari in March 2019. Before arriving at its recommendations, the committee consulted with governors, state chief judges, speakers of the state houses of assembly, civil society organizations, and other relevant stakeholders. From the State House, Adamu Sambu,